ambitious girl. Your drive drives me crazy. I'm trying to stay with you, lay with you. I pay your tuition and pray with you if you ain't in tuition. Aspiration, see? The last one I dated, I hated. We wake up, I go to work. She leave out, come back with some makeup, high heels, and a purse. Worse, I ask her, baby girl, what you aspire to be? And she reply to me like, why you perspiring me? Pardon me if I'm sweating you, but I wanna see something else in you before I invest in you. Ambitious girl, what it's hitting for? I'd rather you tell me to hit you later, cause you gotta finish your paper, than to be in my face asking for a rosé cup. Can't cut in your business. I'm in love with your business, and your productivity is the reason I interest. Ambitious girl, see, I like the person that you are, but I'm in love with the person that you have potential to be. And all your dreams sharing with me, and your secrets bearing with me, and the flaws you don't even gotta mention to me. Ambitious girl, you just wanna win, and you rather chase your dreams than to try to chase these men that try to chase these skirts, that try to chase these shots with flavors that ain't even as sweet as her. My ambitious girl, I won't forget you. I just reflect on how I ain't met you yet, but you somewhere getting your life in order. So for this time being, I hope this open scribe might support her. Support her. The worker.
To thank everybody for coming out tonight. And for everybody that came to my graduation, participated in all of the festivities that I had going on this weekend. I really appreciate you from the bottom of my heart. Like, y'all don't... Oh, Steve, my matter.
Yep.
But for real, y'all don't understand, like, everybody in this room, y'all mean so much to me. Like, I can't even express the words. I can't even form the words to even say how much y'all mean to me. Like, every prayer, every card, every post on social media, just literally everything. I appreciate y'all so much. Like, this has not been an easy journey for me. I can say, like, mentally, during this program, for 3.5 years, I had to quit my job in order to intern, so financially it was not good for me, but, you know, God, that's all I can say, but God, like, literally, when they say he always makes a way, he literally always makes a way, because I'm telling y'all, it's been hard. Like, the program has been very challenging. Like I said, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, I questioned myself a lot. I doubted myself a lot. I didn't think that I was meant for this. I mean, it was a lot of things behind closed doors that people didn't see. I cried myself to sleep many a night, thinking I was going to flunk a test, thinking I wasn't going to do this, and thinking I wasn't going to do that. But look at me, y'all. I feel like I found my purpose. I know when I was like in high school and even in undergrad, I always kept telling myself, I was like, I want to be an FBI profiler or something like that, or work in an FBI field. But once I got in the classroom and started working with kids, I actually got to see firsthand that emotionally that the kids needed help. So, and like, I really love kids. I don't know if people know that, but I really love kids. Kids are drawn to me sometimes. But I really saw that I can make a difference with kids. Like, they listen to me. Like, they, you know, like, my voice is heard with them. So God put being a school counselor on my path. And so here I am today. I just pray to God that I can make a difference, at least in one child. If I can, that'll be enough. I just want to, you know, teach them the correct ways for coping mechanisms. And teach them about mental health altogether, because I'm not sure if you guys know that the suicide rate in young teens and even children ages 7 to 10, they're experiencing depression and seeing a lot of things on social media where they're, you know, committing suicide and things of that nature. So I don't want that for our youth. And so that's why I decided to go into the mental health field. Oh yeah, I do want to send a special shout out to Miss Charles Johnson. Y'all know that's my mom. I really want to thank my mom, like, for literally everything. When I promise, I'm not gonna cry. mean, mama, like, I don't know where I would be without you. Like, you really instilled so much in me. You created, like, the woman I am today besides God. All your talks, even with my doubts that I told you about, like, I wasn't good enough to do this or I wasn't good enough to do that. You helped me see that I am. Like, I belong here. So, yeah, I just want to thank you. Like, I want you to know that everything you did or and still are doing did not go unnoticed. Yeah, I love you so much. Even sometimes when I do treat you like, you know, I don't love you, or if I do treat you, you know, bad, because sometimes y'all didn't know I can't be, you know, some attitude. So, yeah, that's just that. But, mama, I do want you to know that I love you, like, literally with all my heart, and I owe you the world. So, thank you. I love you. We're going to eat, have fun. If y'all want to dance, y'all can. I'm excited. I got my master's. So, yeah!
Donatia's friend. Her mother requested I grab and tell the story. Me and Donatia met when we were 2 years old in the car at her job. She had a baby in the car, and my mama did too. And she was looking out the window and I said, "Hey, little girl." And she just rolled my eyes. So I got out the car. I was like, "You want to be my friend?" And that's how we became friends. We've been friends ever since.
Just want to say congratulations. I'm proud of you. Just keep pushing forward. I mean, if you're thinking about going to get your doctorate, go on ahead, go now. You know, like I said, you got our support, and I love you.
Congratulations, Faye. I am so proud of you. Like, words cannot explain how proud I am of you, girl. I love you. Hey, Pepe. How are you? It's Christian. I just want to wish you well wishes on your graduation. Congratulations. We are so proud of you. Love you. It's nothing but up from here, cousin. And I hope you have the best future ever.
Congratulations, Darnicia, for your getting your master's.
Congratulations, cousin.
Darnicia, I'm so proud of you. Congratulations. This is a big milestone for you, and this is not the last one. You've been through so much getting your master's, and I just want to let you know that this is not the end. It's just to keep going. I love you, and congratulations.
Darnicia, this is your favorite TT Faye. I just want to let you know that I am so proud of you. You are just at the peak of what God is about to do for you. Remember to take God first. Let Him lead you, and all things are possible. This is one of many blessings that He's going to bless you with. And as always, TT loves you, and I am so proud of you.
Congratulations, Darnicia. I'm happy for you. I know this has been a long time coming. It's up from here. The price that went up. Have fun. Enjoy your life. You can do it.
Congratulations, Darnicia. I am so proud of you. We met in 2015, and you have had the heart of gold, the spirit that just attracts positivity. You have had the most genuine impact on my life, and I'm just so proud of you. I don't know. I can't wait to see what you do with me.
Hey, cousin. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you. Keep going up. Keep doing everything you set your mind to, because you got it, baby. The price just went up. Congratulations, cousin. I love you.
First off, congratulations, dude. We've been waiting on this for I don't know how long. You know what I'm saying? I would have never thought this would be what you did, seeing it. Since fourth grade, you've been saying you want to be like an FBI agent. But life is life, and I'm so proud of you. Congratulations, Doug.
Hey, bestie, I just want to say congratulations. You know how it is with us. You know, I always tell you to keep going. I keep pushing you, keep motivating you to be your best self, no matter what. You know, I'm always happy. I'm always here to support you, love you. I care for you. You already know what it is when it comes to me and you. My best friend for life since fucking sixth grade, excuse my language. But I just want to tell you congratulations. You know, I'm going to always be here with you every step of the way. Always have, always will be. And we always going to keep turning up. every time. Every time, you know, I always tell you to keep chasing your dreams. And you're doing that. And I'm real proud of you. I think you know that. You know, I tell you that all the time. I just want to say I love you so, so, so much with everything. Thank you for always being here, being my friend, being a sister, just being everything. Like, literally half of me.